Mic on? We on.
Oh.
Off of another short hiatus.
Very short hiatus, like 3 weeks, two
what
weeks.
We like to call it hiatus.
Yeah. I mean, people who live in LA know that it's difficult to get over here to the Valley.
No, we're not making excuses.
If you live in Los Angeles,
I'm not making excuses.
We record in the Valley, but I have to come from like Santa Monica.
I don't want to hear. I don't want to hear.
So
you coming.
It is.
I don't want to hear about you coming.
It is difficult. Okay. But I made it. I'm here. I'm excited because it's Halloween.
It's Halloween, my guy.
Everyone be safe out there. All my friends are going to Halloween-y. You guys have fun. Halloween is downtown. It's a big, big costume party. And I think all the proceeds goes to the gay men's chorus or something like that, or some type of gay charity. No, yeah.
The
or
gay
whatever.
Murder, the gay murderers thing.
I've gone for a few years and a couple years. I enjoyed it thoroughly, so I am having FOMO a little bit. Yes, I am. So
that's gonna be the cover. I just took a picture.
Huh?
That's gonna be the cover of this week's.
Please don't. Yeah, I have to approve it first.
No, we're not. All right. Welcome back to Would You Like a Podcast.
Welcome back, guys.
With Kelby and Devion.
Patricia.
For a person who just woke up, I have a lot of energy. So, how are you? Number one.
I'm good. I'm a little tired.
Facts. You want the rest of that energy drink?
I do not, because I do want to go to sleep soon.
Okay.
Because it's Friday, and if I don't go out on Friday, I have to go to sleep. Mm-hmm. Or I will end up partying somewhere. Like going out dancing.
No, yeah.
That's what I mean.
No, yeah, of course. I'm worried about you, too, sometimes.
What about me doing for
you,
what?
You party better than anybody that I know.
I can just stay up better than most people that you know. That's pretty much it. Okay. Usually, when I always say party, it's usually consistent. It's usually me going out to some bar with some friends, and we just end up at somebody's house, kicking the whole night.
Well, I love all the kikis in the world. Not sure. Oh, kiki like laughing.
Kiki, like kiki, talking, hanging out. That's what a kiki is. A kiki is just a kiki is a party with your friends.
Okay.
You just sitting around talking. And
so we kikiing right now.
We're working, but
oh yeah, lit. Let's look.
I'm gonna open this.
Okay.
This. Yeah. We're working, but yeah, when we get together, we kiki.
Okay.
Me, you, Red, Bree, Chris, all of us.
You know Chris?
Crystal.
Oh, Crystal. Yes. Okay. Boy, I had something on. Oh, okay. Do you want kids?
Do I want kids?
Yeah.
Like
maybe. To take care of them at some point.
Maybe I'm like 40 or 50.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Maybe late 30s, 38.
40s or 50? I didn't expect that.
I used to want them really bad. I used to want my first kid by the time I was 23.
That's how you know you're from the South.
Yeah, I wanted kids. Sorry,
I wanted kids when I was 21. When I was a kid.
Yeah, I wanted my first kid when I was super young, and I wanted like 13 of them.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted moved to six. LA and realized how expensive shit is.
Go ahead. Talk, and, King.
And people say, a lot of people say, like, you know, when you don't have kids, your 30s are magical because you just end up kind of finding your rhythm and getting a job and making good money. And when you don't have to spend any of your money on kids, you pretty much have a kind of a fun time. So I'm kind of looking forward to that. I think I'm on that track.
On the incline.
On the incline. I'm pretty excited about it.
I asked because I got a splash and a whiff of baby fever. Like, it came and then it went.
Okay.
That doesn't sound correct. Talking about kids coming in.
Oh, I want to eat Snickers.
Yeah. Eat them. I don't know. I don't know who they're for.
I'm going to eat another.
Okay.
You got some baby fever? Baby fever.
I saw a video on Facebook of like a dad and a daughter. And it got
the banana one.
Shoot, I probably did see it because I went on a daddy daughter video tirade. I've seen them all now in the world.
Oh yeah, I watched a lot of baby videos.
Oh my gosh, it got me. And then a friend of mine was like, "Man, these bills, for these hospital bills for this baby that she just had." I said, "Oh yeah."
Well, it's expensive. Do you know that daycare out here is super expensive? Preschool, you have to sign up when you're pregnant.
You wait, what?
You have to like get on wait list when you're pregnant. You like, there was a school that I used to work at. It's like $40,000 a year.
Oh no!
And it's a like daycare.
Oh no, no, no!
They're expensive.
No, no, no. If I have children, they have to go to the worst schools and the ones that are bit like they have to pay me for the, down, to send like, them Inglewood down. Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, come on now! Don't marginalize.
I'm not marginalized. I don't say anything about race.
I don't know what that means, man.
I was at the Pie Pies down in Inglewood today. I'm like a little nervous. I get very scared when I go into a business and they have bulletproof. No, they have bulletproof glass. Bulletproof glass. Sorry, I got Snickers on. Oh my god, I almost fell. I'm not drunk. Sadly. But yeah, and I was like, okay, I don't want to be that guy, but. I don't want to be here. I was like, I feel like the one on Hollywood and Highland needs that Hollywood
and Vine
and Cahuenga. Is it Cahuenga? Popeyes. It's Cahuenga, I think.
Yeah, it is.
Cahuenga needs the bulletproof glass. Not that anybody's shooting, but it's kind of really gross.
I have now realize that I've been to a Popeyes with a bulletproof glass. That's the Popeyes that they put the extra seasoning in the chicken. That's good. Yeah, there's a reason people are shooting up Popeyes.
Popeyes is delicious. I eat it weekly.
Wait, really?
Yeah, I love Popeyes. I always get like usually like a Monday or a Tuesday. I get like the deal they have. They don't have that anymore. They have a $10 box where you get 5 pieces and 2 sides.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a good deal. I would
love to have $10. It's a great deal.
And then they have a $5 deal where you get 5 pieces. And then they have a $20-something deal where you get, like, some more stuff. But I haven't.
Go ahead. Hey, you know what? We're done talking about Popeyes because they don't pay us.
Promotion for Popeyes. You guys want to sponsor us. You know what I mean?
Nah, they don't pay
us. Come through, Popeyes. Come through with the biscuits with the honey.
As if Popeyes would be the one to give us money. They'd be like, look, y'all got a podcast?
Popeyes always in the hood, though, or in the worst parts of town.
Yeah.
They're never. It's kind of like Wendy's. Wendy's is kind of moving up a little bit, but.
No, it's not. I passed by.
I was in the worst part of town.
I was in a really nice part of town. I saw Burger King and McDonald's. And then across the street, I saw some shooting, a couple kids skipping school, and right behind them was a Wendy's.
What's Wendy's?
And they was all just saying, fo, 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 fo.
Yeah, Wendy's is in the hood, too. I like Wendy's. I like even that chili. I know you're not supposed to eat it, but man, every like couple of months, I go there. I eat it. Did you know McDonald's took the spicy chicken stuff off the menu?
Not all of them. I saw it today at a McDonald's, and I was like, oh, praise be.
I didn't see it, and I was like, oh, okay, cool. I was thinking about going to get that, but I got pokey instead.
I've seen people been eating this pokey.
Oh, I love pokey.
I don't know what it is. I ain't eating it.
It's pretty much like sushi in a bowl.
I ain't eating that.
It's good. I like it.
I don't like fish in a bowl.
It's raw fish.
I don't like
some white
wrong.
People shit.
Honestly. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was like, man,
it's definitely some white people shit. All
right, so this little black girl says that she's white.
I saw that bullshit. I think it's definitely fake. I don't think it's real.
I don't think it's ratings. I don't think it's 100% fake. You know why?
Why?
Because I know a lot of people who feel like that.
Who think. Okay, this is
no. Feel but not think. Feel but not think.
That's it. If you have the
she's 16.
The smallest dose of common sense,
mm-hmm.
You would know that being a race does not dictate. Let me make sure I say this correctly, though, so I can make sure people understand what I'm saying. Being white is not one definition. Like being black is not one definition. Like the whole race of Dozar thing. Being black is not being this, being that. Just because you're black doesn't mean your hair. You should wear dreads or you should rock a Rock-A-Wear or FUBU.
I thought it did.
It doesn't necessarily mean that. And just because you're white doesn't mean that you speak a certain way. Doesn't mean that you believe a certain thing. People have to stop with this bullshit.
But Devion, you're 33 years old.
I am not 33, motherfucker. You will not do that to me.
Okay, she's a little girl. She's 16 years old.
She's on TV.
Yeah, because she has an eccentric way of thinking. But I will say, did you see what... I'm not sure if I should say his name, but He wrote on Facebook, like, he explained that he kind of felt the same when he was in high school.
I don't know. I mean, I used to wish I was white. What black person did?
I never wanted to be white, but I wanted to be lighter. Black person didn't used to
want
to
be white. You know, white, light skin. Yeah, it's easier. The darker you are, the rougher your life is in most places. So it's like, you know what I mean? It's understandable to wish, but to say I am a white person inside, or to say that I am an Asian person because I'm very good at math, based off stereotypes or something like that.
That could be true, though.
That's what's wrong. Like, that, we have to stop that. We have to stop those people from doing shit like that. That's stupid.
All right, listen. This is what I'm gonna say. His name.
Don't say his name. Just show me.
I'm gonna read it. He wrote, "I was like this in high school at the same exact age. She will wake up soon enough and it will shatter her world." Somebody responded and said, "Hey, can I ask you what made you think that?" And he said, "I had moved to Florida from Boston and treated like ish by my own, by only my fellow black people. Oh, so I lashed out in middle school, in high school. I was full blown delusional. Our college, whatever that school was, actually saved me. It was the first
time.
Our
college was predominantly white.
Hold up, listen. I lost my place. I could communicate with. Wait, no. It saved me, and it was the first time I could communicate with and actually feel like I was black." The person continues to say.
I think I know who this is. You can call the person X or something like that. Give him a fake name.
Virgil.
Hey, Virgil. Oh, yo, nigga ass.
Oh, hey. She hasn't met the right black people.
Oh, my God.
Hold up. The right black people for her to see herself in them. Nor has she looked in the mirror and really seen and taken in who and what she is looking, what is looking back at her. It isn't self-hate. It's more so self-ignorance. She doesn't know better, so she doesn't do better. To her, she isn't right or wrong. She believes these are facts. It's crazy, TBH.
Can you show me the person that you're talking about? Like, I want to guess.
Like, mouth it. No.
No? Oh, really? Oh, my Atlanta. Girl, bye.
Like, I mean, yo, you can't discredit, you know.
I'm not discrediting, but I'm just saying, I that's my reaction to it. It's like, yeah, we all, I think, and especially me, I used to think I was super ugly and was super bad and hard on myself and thought it was because of the color of my skin because, you know, I was different. And I was, you know, for me, it was most of the time, I was gay. All people I knew were black people. But you do not, it's not because you are a different race. It's not, and
but
the way,
you know,
she's,
this
the
now.
Way she's doing it is because she thinks she's better than, but she, the way even what she said, well, black people have big lips and this, black people are this, black people are this. It's coming from this hierarchy place that white people are above you, and so am I.
Well, yeah, that's what she's trying to say.
I know that's what she's saying,
but
and
she's
it doesn't
16.
Correlate to,
essentially what she's saying is the people around me have made it.
She need her ass whooping by her mama. I'm sorry, I don't condone violence, but sometimes some children need their ass whooped. I got mine whooped several times. You know, some people just need It's so annoying. It's so annoying. Oh, I'm so over her. Bye, hashtag.
She's about to. I bet you she's gonna come out with a song.
Give me the
because she was on Dr. Phil.
I know.
Phil made Catch Me Outside Girl.
He made her. She thinks she's black too, don't she?
Yeah, that's funny. That's like the.
I'm eating the last Snickers.
Yeah. All right. Well, I don't know who it's for, so.
I've already eaten the other two.
Hey, yeah, whatever.
Don't snitch.
I'm gonna snitch. Yeah. So I mean, I don't know. I don't know what my reaction to it is because it's like it's not new right now, but I do understand that somebody around her is making her feel like she ain't worth it.
Somebody
and
around
she going she gonna get
feel
it.
Like shit. Like,
yeah.
Oh, she just need help. She need a good therapist.
Yeah.
Some mom need to pay
and she
good
got
money.
she got Disney villain gaps in her teeth.
She's 16, trying to leave her alone. Don't talk about her appearance. She's 600.
No, what I'm saying is she got the blackest of blackest features, man. What? You know, that's what I'm saying. Like, and she's not like mixed. She's black.
What? Natural straight hair. You got. She knows she took a flat iron to her head. Your head don't go like that. Our head don't go like that, sis. I'm sorry.
Hey, man. You know, it is.
I wish I had straight hair for a long time. Like, I wish. Because my nickname in my family is BB, because I had, they called me the Kunta hair. I had nigga hair. Or half nigga hair. My hair is horrible.
Nigga hair.
And I got BB shots, and I hated that. And then, you know, in black families, you saw what it is. In black families, they pick the worst thing about you and make that your nickname.
Yo, I have come to realization. I had a conversation with somebody recently, and you know how black people are, man. We make fun of you, you know, just to make you feel better, to make you feel worse. We just make fun of you in general,
yeah.
You know, and so this person was feeling under the weather, you know. And I kind of made fun of him, you know, a little light jab. They busted out in tears.
Yeah, you gotta be careful, people out here. They a little sensitive.
They oversensitive. And it wasn't a black person. I feel like if it was a black person, they'd have laughed and they say, "You so stupid, boy."
They would have laughed, or they would have came had a comeback for you.
Yeah, I'll take it. You know.
Yeah.
Shoot, I'll never forget. In high school, I was cracking on somebody hard, and he said, "That's why I don't know. That's why you don't know if you be sucking on a girl's titties or your own." I said, "Oh, I'm gonna shut up."
Like, all right,
I got you. I'm gonna go sit down
with your ugly ass.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
He was pretty too, so I couldn't say that.
You lucky, you pretty.
Shoot. All right. Okay. Hey, come on. All right. So. Pete Davidson and Ariana Grande breakup.
I know, so sad. I mean, I think that's just due to Mac Miller. I think that's due in part. I mean, they were together for a very long time.
Let me thicken the plot for you.
Okay.
They say Peter Davidson sent Mac Miller.
I heard that. Yeah.
A picture or a video of him in the cheeks.
I think I think that was rude, and if it's true, I think that was horrible for him to do. I don't put when someone commits suicide or anything like that, or overdose or anything like that, I don't put the blame on anybody else.
Well, okay, I'm not saying all that,
but it probably did have a big play in it, because from my understanding, he really wanted Ariana back, from what I've been reading in the tabloids.
They loved each other,
but Ariana could not.
Handle his
abuse of drugs. Abusing drugs is something else, y'all. Y'all gotta stop doing that shit. but seriously, know when to say when. Shit, just know your limit. Know when to stop. Know what you can and can't do. If you tried a whole bunch of shit, cool. You ain't gotta do a whole bunch of shit. You can know what's pick your poison. Like, you know what I mean? It's all a risk. All of it is, but know what you're doing and be around good people when you do it. Anywho, but I don't know much about Pete Davidson at all. I didn't even think he was cute until like a couple of minutes ago. But yeah, if he sent that dude message and stuff like that, that's some petty ass bullshit, and that's some bitch shit.
No, it is.
That's some bitch shit. And I don't mean bitch by woman standard. I just mean bitch by bitch. Like, he being some bitch right now.
Facts. Rita Ora dresses up like Post Malone, starts a wave. Joey Fatone, I think from...
She did what? Can I see?
Yeah, I'm bringing it up right now.
She dressed up like Post Malone.
Is
that her Halloween thing?
Yep. You know who Rita Ora is.
I do. I like some of her music. Oh, cool. That's actually really good.
It is very good. And now
she looks trans.
Joey Fatone is doing.
Oh, like she looks like she could be a.
Oh shoot, what's that?
You know what I mean? Okay. Like she's transitioning or something. That's really good.
She did it at a concert. People thought it was really post.
She did that whole thing at her concert.
Yeah. Like, here's the video.
She did her whole concert at Post Malone.
Yeah. It's cool.
That's really good.
Yeah, it is.
You said Joe Fatone did whom? Who's Joe Fatone? He one of the people was in NSYNC.
Yeah, he was in a boy band. But
NSYNC, NSYNC, right?
That's what Joe, Joey Fatone.
Because I was thinking of the other Joey from the brothers, Joey.
He has a lot of gray hair. Oh, he's gay. Oh, wait, no, he's not.
Mans Bass is gay.
Oh, okay. Here he is, dressed up now as Post Malone. His isn't as good.
He just wrote underneath his eye. Oh, he got a tattoo on his neck, too. Okay.
Everybody wants to be Post Malone.
I don't even know what he's saying, except congratulations.
Rock star.
Party like a rock.
No. I've been popping pillies and no one like a rock star.
Oh, okay. I know that.
And, of course, yeah.
That melody, like a rock star.
Yeah. And then he also had the song with Ty Dolla $ign that got pretty big. Let's see if I can find it.
Ty Dolla $ign.
Do you like him?
I don't know much about him. I don't think I couldn't tell you a single thing he's saying. Couldn't tell you not one thing. Not a single thing. I'm curious why his name is Ty Dolla $ign, though. Kind of like it. I actually like it a lot.
Yeah. I'm with it.
And we're back with the morning news.
Oh, here it is. It's called Psycho.
Psycho. I don't know. Post Malone looks like he's from Trailer Park, Mississippi.
Yes, he does. And then they go psycho. Mama bad like Michael.
Oh, I do know this song.
Yeah. So now you know three or four Post Malone songs.
I know them. Yeah. If I'm out and they play them in
the club.
Yeah.
I heard him in the club.
I went to a Drake concert last weekend.
How was it? I know you went to Drake's concert.
I did. I went with Redman. Let me get my bag for a second.
Okay.
Guys, Drake is a cultural icon. Nobody ever talked poorly about him. Nobody claims he loses in a beef from here on out. Nobody says anything bad about him or hurts his feelings. Period. And that's that.
Okay.
That guy's amazing.
So I take it you liked the concert.
That concert was amazing, except the Migos.
Didn't Cardi B come out with the Migos?
Not at the Drake concert. Not at the Drake concert that I went to.
But she did, right?
She did, one of them. And I think it was in Louisville or something like that.
Did he have like three here in LA?
He had four.
Four nights? Okay.
Two at Forum, two at Staples Center.
Why?
Because one is in Inglewood and the other one is in LA.
That ain't that far apart.
I don't know. Well, who knows? Maybe the Forum had somebody else booked. You know.
Oh, I was like, the forum ain't that far. I just came from Inglewood. It took me 20 minutes to get here. I'm bottom in the valley. No, it took me 30 minutes to get here, actually. But Staples is in downtown LA. I feel like that's close. Isn't downtown closer to Inglewood than
Valley? Inglewood is a good 40 minutes away. Yeah. 30 to 40 minutes away.
I guess when you live in LA, you're used to that kind of distance. Everything takes you at least 20 minutes.
Yeah, everything is 20 minutes. It's an hour, 20 minutes.
Everything's going to be at least 20 minutes.
You trying to get to San Diego? It's 2 hours and 20 minutes.
2 hours and 20 minutes.
Literally, everything is 20 minutes.
Everything is about 20 minutes.
Unless there's traffic, then it's about 4 hours.
Yeah.
But it's 20 minutes. 20 minutes. At 11 o'clock at night, you get you.
Let's go Dodgers. Did we win today?
Let's find out. Okay, Google.
Hey, Siri, did the Dodgers win today?
The Dodgers win today.
Oh, my phone is dying, so never mind.
I'm flattered to be mistaken for Siri. I love Siri a lot. I even wrote it a poem. Google is red, Google is blue, apples are sweet, and Siri is too.
You salty.
Oh, nice. Hey.
Did the Dodgers win? I'm gonna ask you about
Currently,
Siri.
The Dodgers are tied with the Red Sox 2-2 in the top of the 14th.
Oh shit, they still playing?
For the top of the 14th. Goodness.
Damn.
Let's Wait, go the Dodgers are down 2.
Huh?
The Dodgers
They're
are down
2. Yeah, they need to win this game.
Oh, they're going to lose.
Don't say that. It's World Series.
No, they're going to lose.
Let's win, Dodgers.
Yo,
let's go Dodgers.
I know you don't know anything about football. But the New York Giants they did just sign Corey Coleman. I've played with him on Madden 5 billion times, and he's a fantastic player. So hopefully that does something for us. Okay, back to Drake. The Migos are super, super trash. Every like when the Migos came out, everybody just sat down.
Did they really?
Yeah.
I thought Migos get people real hype.
They don't. First of all, the music is super loud. There's one guy who just walks around saying his ad-libs. Takeoff needed a large espresso. He sat down for most of his performance.
He was probably tired.
Oh no. I'm tired of making millions.
I wouldn't. I wonder who won that lottery.
Some girl in South Carolina.
South Carolina.
In South Carolina.
Man.
That's 800 million. After tax, it'll be about 400 million. Yeah.
Hurts. I bought one ticket, though.
Did you?
I just bought one.
I heard about it only maybe like 2 days before.
Yeah, I heard about when I was in my donut shop that morning getting my breakfast. And
like, yo, you really be eating out like that.
Yeah, dude.
And eating in other places.
It's funny because it's true.
Yeah, I don't know. The lotto to me is just
entertaining. I mean, that was tempting. That was just kind of like, wow, that's a lot of money. Might as well just kind of put your hat in.
You're not going to win.
Yeah, you just like you just put your hat in there and just see what happens.
When it's $4 million, I'm going to buy 30 tickets.
It keeps going. It's like at 40 million right now.
That's what I'm saying. Like when it's low.
When it's low.
Oh, I'm buying the tickets. We getting it in.
I put $2 in there. So you're welcome.
Right. Woman in South Carolina.
I gave you $2, bitch. You welcome.
Okay. One of those dollars goes to the government.
You should bring me back my money.
Let's see. Okay, so the Dodgers are losing. Drake is an icon. Mm-hmm. Joey Fatone is Joey Malone. I'll see. Do you listen to any of the albums that came out?
What came out? I've been working so much.
You gotta stop. I need to go on vacation. I'm getting my passport.
I've been working so much. I listened to Nao, I think is how you say her name. Her album came out today. She's like this indie soul artist.
Okay.
Her album is pretty good. Cardi B new song. I don't like it. Sorry.
I'm not going to say I don't like it, but I didn't love it.
I think I just don't like her
voice.
It's
a little vulgar to me.
I just don't like her voice. I feel like she's reading like a cue card or something. Or like, I don't know. Like, you know, it's a rap for kids trying to learn how to read. I like Cardi B as a celebrity. And yeah, like,
for sure.
I do like her album. As a fun thing, but I don't know, something I am not connecting, and that's what I hate, because I want to connect. I want to like hear Cardi B and just like I love it, but I don't. And you know, music is subjective, so everybody's not gonna like your stuff.
So this artist named Joji dropped a new album called Ballads One. You heard of it?
I heard of her.
Okay, that's hard.
She's on a Black Panther album.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's one of my favorite songs on that album.
Okay, I'm going to have to check that out. Good singer. Tory Lanez with Love Me Now. Jeremiah Dollar and Ty Dolla Sign with My Ty. It's an album.
Who's this person Usher is singing with? He released Zaytoven. An album.
Zaytoven is he's a producer.
Oh, so he's not like a singer? No. Why's his name credited?
That's a popular thing nowadays.
To credit a producer?
Yeah. A lot of people do it. Big Sean did it. Future does it all the time. Zaytoven is one of Future's guys.
Oh, okay.
Like, they work together all the time.
I like that name, Zaytoven.
Made in Tokyo, new album. There's a new album, like, oh my gosh, every day. Nao, Saturn.
Yeah, Nao, that's the one. That
Lucas Graham.
Lucas Graham is white.
Yeah, he's white. We don't, Robin.
Neither does. Yes, Robin. Yes, for all the gays. Robin is back with some new shit.
It's called Honey.
Yeah, I haven't listened to it yet because I haven't been in a real gay mood. But you know what I mean. Like but Robin has some new music.
You gonna watch that Halloween movie?
I want to really bad. I think I'm gonna do it next week.
I haven't seen any trailer for it.
I heard it was pretty good. I've seen some like little teasers.
Let's read a review. That could be funny. Let's read the worst review.
For Halloween?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead, read it. I can't read.
Yeah, I'm starting to be bad at reading out loud. Okay, Halloween. It gets a 79 fresh rating.
Yeah, it got a pretty good rating.
Man, that's dope.
It's best for a horror movie.
Yeah. It's one of the biggest openings for a horror movie after It. So let's go ahead and find a horrible review.
Like a one-star review?
Yeah.
I mean, I know I think I've seen every Halloween movie from the first one all the way except for this one. This is the only one I haven't seen.
So I didn't even know
big,
there was multiple.
I'm a big fan of the series. And from what my understanding, this one kind of eliminates. This one takes place right after Halloween 2. So it eliminates Halloween 4, 5, 6. Because 1 and
there's
2.
There's 6 of them?
There's 8 of them.
Goodness.
Wait. Nope. Wait, hold on. I think that's Halloween 4, 5, 6. There's Halloween H2O. Okay. Halloween 20. Sorry, not H2O. I just call it H2O. Halloween Resurrection.
Okay. This is Rex Reed with The Observer. He's a top critic. Says, what once seemed creepy now just seems campy. I'm sorry to report that in the 2018 Halloween, the howls sound more like giggles than screams. Go check it out, y'all.
He mad.
Yeah,
he's mad. Why are you mad, though, bruh? Do you know Beyoncé has this secret Instagram called Rose5 or something like that? Is anybody following Beyoncé's secret Instagram?
How do you know about this?
Because I'm a stan. And I follow it, and they post these random weird shit. And I have no idea what it's about. Frank Ocean posted something. And the only people that are following it is Beyoncé. The only people it follows is Beyoncé, Kelly, Nicki Minaj, Tidal, and Netflix.
Rose.
It's like Rose Force, Rose Ivy, or I don't know, Rose something. Rose Ivy, I think, is actually what it is.
Let's see what she got here. Rose Ivy. Rose. Oh, okay, Rose For You. Okay.
Rose For You. Do you see it?
And it has 27,000 followers.
It's like black. Oh, like black photos? Yeah. No idea what it is about.
50 Cent was doing that for a bit.
Huh?
50 Cent. He was like posting weird stuff for like 3 weeks.
Was it? It's for promotion though. This has been going on for a while, I feel like.
I don't think that's her secret.
She just posted it. I say secret just because it's like it's not Beyonce. I'm sure Beyonce has a secret Instagram
she snoops and stuff.
Because her Beyonce Instagram, she doesn't follow anybody. Mm-hmm. Like, but I'm sure she has one where she's following her friends and like it's kind of like a normal person. But.
Yeah, for sure. And all these pictures are like blurry.
Yeah, some people say it's hinting at her and Kelly having a duet album or like.
Why she got to revive Kelly like that?
That's her best friend. Let her do what she wants to do. She got all the money. She got all the money in the world. She got all the fame, all the celebrity. She ain't got nothing else to prove.
Wait, so who told you about this?
I always look up Beyonce stuff all the time, so I just kind of stumbled upon it.
Oh, interesting. Okay, I'm going to read something to you.
Okay.
Breaking news. 50 Cent buys 200 front row seats to Ja Rule concert off Groupon, so it'll be empty.
No, that's so petty. Oh, that's so good. That's so petty. His beef is so 1996.
Yo, listen, man. It's not, but yes.
Like Murder, Inc. Come on, sit down.
Yo, look at this picture of 50 Cent.
That's not real.
No, it's not. But to buy the tickets off of Groupon, and what he said in the caption was, LOL, at $15 a pop, you can't lose. I got 200 tickets for $3,000.
I can't.
Yo, just to think about going to the Drake concert was $150.
That's how much it was for Drake?
$150? Nah, I didn't.
You didn't pay? You got Sugar Mama?
Listen, man. If you listen,
you got a sugar daddy.
I need me a sugar mama. I needs me one.
Sugar mama.
So if you wanna give me diabetes, you know. Okay. Let's see what else we got.
It's been a slow 3 weeks, huh?
No, it has.
Oh, we haven't recorded at night in a long time either, though. So I think that's true. We usually record during the daytime.
Hey, so you don't get heartbroken anymore, huh?
What do you mean? Everyone gets heartbroken.
No. You used to be
broken. No.
You used to be heartbreak dev.
I did. Yeah. Long way I've come, huh?
You know, now you're
fuck them.
I think that's what you do. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm all out of fucks to give.
So you know, yeah, you don't do the heartbreak anymore.
No. I take people for what they give me, in a sense. Like, if I'm feeling you out and we like have a connection or whatever, mm-hmm. and I want to take it further, I am the bitch that's gonna let you know. Mm-hmm. You never have to wonder if I like you or what I'm feeling. I always say, you know what? Hey, I kind of want to like see you or get to know you better, talk to you. And if you, there's this guy that like works in West Hollywood that I've talked to for a little bit, just like two or three weeks, and mm-hmm. He knows how I feel, but he's kind of like that way of like, mm-hmm. yeah, but you know, he'll say stuff like I'm crazy and this and this.
He says that?
Yeah,
Mike.
Not about me, but about him.
Like he says he's crazy.
Yeah,
that's how you know they're not crazy.
And that's why I'm like, okay, I said, cool. Either you in this or you're not. I ain't asked you to be my boyfriend. I'm just saying, hey.
I want you to just hop up on it.
That happened. But I just, like, you know what I mean? Like, I like you. Let's hang out.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you're gay, you have sex with somebody first and then, like, you see if you can hang out
with them. I don't say that because somebody's going to listen and be like, I don't do that. I don't have sex with nobody till the ninth month.
Then you're lame.
Dang.
No, I'm just playing. I'm joking. Please don't be that person that takes everything that seriously. That but anyway, no, I was just like, I would come in, I'll see him at work, because when I go out, I'll see him every once in a while, and he'll like say, oh yeah, I miss you, or this and that, and I'm like, old me would have been like, oh, I miss you too, and this and this, and like, oh, I just want them to call me. And then new me is kind of like, well, nigga, you got my number. So, if you know how I feel. I told you I liked you. I told you what. I told you I was down for whatever.
Let me ask you the essential question here.
Yeah, what is it?
Are they black?
Yeah, they're black in something.
No, that's a no.
They're black in something. They're not. They're maybe a shade lighter than me.
Okay.
Yeah, so, and I'm pretty dark.
You like black guys?
Yeah. I don't discriminate based off race. The spaces that I'm usually in are predominantly white.
Well, I just figured since, you know, you're not verse like that, you know, you want to avoid the pain.
That means I don't take dick up my ass.
Okay, come on.
Yeah. I did go hook up with this guy, though, and he had the biggest dick I've ever seen in my whole entire life. I was sitting there laying beside him and just staring at it.
Oh, my gosh.
It was, he said it was 12 inches, and I believe him. It was so big. It was the biggest thing I've ever seen in my life. He was black.
Oh, my God.
And he's like, I think he's African or something. Like, anyway, but.
Well.
We ended up like, watching some of his homemade porn, which was some of the hottest things I've ever seen. I was like, these guys live out here? They are so sexy.
What do you mean, these people?
How
does this happen? Yeah, we just watched this homemade porn. It was him, Ray J.
It was him and a lot of like these really hot, sexy men that most of them just happened to be men of color. Which I was just like, oh my God, I've never. And he was like, well, next time we have some of these parties, you can come. I said, I can't be recorded. I can't compete with 12 inches.
Okay, wait. He got the 12er, and you gave it to him?
I know. We just we did a like kind of like a jack off session, but like
I bet your shoulder's on fire right now.
My shoulders?
Yeah.
This is a minute ago.
Oh, okay.
This was maybe like last week.
That's not a minute ago.
Like 2 weeks ago. All I know is it was the biggest thing I've ever seen. Because I have a habit of when I go out, I'll go out and party and like I'll just stay up. And I stayed up and I was like just thinking about it, like, oh my God, that was so big.
Why you ain't go back?
Because I no.
Does your jaw hurt?
No, my jaw. No, it surprisingly no. But I took it like a champ. Through my mouth, I gave him a really good blowjob, I think. But
you think?
Yeah, that was. I don't know why I told that story. Yeah.
Okay, so this guy that you are you talking to?
I'm not talking to anybody right now. It's Halloween.
Oh yeah.
Fuck it, I'm single.
You know, scary booty's the best booty. I mean,
I'm going to this party tomorrow, and last time I went, I go to this party every year, and I think like maybe like the second year I went, standing in line to get in. Me and some friends, and the line was super long, and they just hadn't worked out how to like
rotate them.
Mm-hmm. And I was like, "Fuck, this is taking a long time." So some dude hit me. Some dude I used to mess with. I left the line, went to this dude's car. We hooked up in his car. Oh my gosh. Came back, still in line.
Let me ask you this.
So hopefully the line is
not because your life is wild.
I do have a kind of a wild life. Wild but safe, guys.
I was about to ask, like, when you rolling out the house, you like, yo, let me go get my Durex.
Lube and stuff?
No, condoms.
There's condoms everywhere. Everyone has condoms. It's not hard to find.
So you're using that?
Yeah, sure. You ask me that question every week.
I know.
I wish you would stop.
No. It's important.
Yeah, I go to gay clubs. There's condoms in bathrooms.
Wow.
They're very accessible, honey.
I didn't even think about
it. And just because I hook up doesn't mean... Hook up doesn't always mean just actual, like, full penetrative sex.
It don't matter. You know? Shoot. Some form of protection, you know?
Yeah.
I just be making sure.
Nah.
You know how many things floating out there? They got super, super AIDS. Oh, God. They just came out.
You came out with a mixtape yesterday.
No, yeah, that's actually a little super AIDS. Okay. There's this guy that hits me up.
For what? For
sex? Always after 11 p.m.
Ha ha.
And he is, you know.
He's gay?
Yeah. He's on the other side. Does that.
He's on the other side?
On the other side. Yeah.
Uh huh.
Does that mean. Am I okay?
What do you mean? Are you okay? Black men are not. I mean, gay men are not criminals or
not gonna like that. It's like I'm saying, is he hitting on me?
After 11, what is he saying to you? I don't know. It depends.
He just be hitting me
I
up.
I could text you after 11 o'clock.
It's not like that. It's like, hey, what you doing? Sleeping.
Are you sleeping after 11 o'clock? He just hits you up randomly.
Yeah, always at night. Always late at night.
Maybe he just went out and was drunk and was hitting because he thought about you.
So he thinks I'm cute?
I don't know what he thinks.
Yeah, I need because you to know.
I don't know. Probably. It sounds like yes. But like I'll go out and I'll hit up never people. Text me. And I'll hit up people and I don't want sex. I don't want anything. I don't want anything like that. I just want to hang out because these are people I'm used to hanging out with. And usually it's probably people I'm used to hanging out with at this time. And a lot of those, some of those people are straight guys. That I hang out with after the bars close and we just hang out and kick it and chill and kiki. So,
of course,
you know,
Of course, the kiki has to end too.
So yeah, I'll be like, oh, what you doing? Where you at? What's happening? Is anything happening? I will send, is anything happening tonight text to almost anybody.
I've and never gotten
like
one.
And it's kind of like me on Grindr. I will be sitting in my bed. Half asleep.
Messing with an African.
texting people. And then just like ended up crashing and nothing comes of it ever.
I'm not. I just want to know if I'm being complimented so I feel good. This week.
You have to show me the text message.
This week, two women. I'm going to say this slowly because it felt great. Called me pretty. On the same day.
They call you pretty?
I know. I was like, me?
Why they use that word? It said like no, handsome don't say, no, or don't like.
Say that. I'll take it. Pretty.
Take yeah. Actually, take every compliment that comes to you. But
heck yeah,
it's odd for a woman to call you pretty. Maybe they thought you were gay.
Okay.
Come, you are pretty, Kelby. You're messing, pretty, don't, pretty, pretty, pretty.
Don't
pretty
don't, boy. Be mess, don't be messing me up like that.
This right here is my swag. Other, that's what Cardi B kind of reminds me of. Soulja Boy. As a girl, kinda.
She's better. She delivers a little bit better than Soulja
Pretty Soulja Boy. Pretty Boy Swag. Pretty Boy Swag.
Can you believe Soulja Boy's still a thing?
Soulja Boy up in his heart. Is he still a thing? He has a thing. He has a pretty big following, huh?
It's crazy. Him still a thing. Bow Wow.
Bow Wow ain't a thing. Bow Wow's trying. But
No. Bow Wow is still a thing. He may not be the thing, but he's a thing.
He doesn't have a pretty big following, though, does he?
Bow Wow?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was on my Insta the other day. Follow me at Dev Drez. You can. I just post pictures of my ass all the time. It's a nice ass.
That booty is so small and so tight.
Who?
You!
Yeah, my ass is nice.
No, I didn't say that.
That's what I heard.
you can't put a quarter in that thing.
It is tight. I got muscle booty. I work it out.
That's not what I
do. I'm so sexy.
And look at this before and after picture of Katy Perry.
Money.
Yo, listen. Katy Perry's real.
People
pretty.
Say money can't solve your problems. Money can solve literally every problem I got.
Girl, tell me. Okay, so Soulja Boy got 4.2 million followers.
Oh, million.
4.2 million.
Get it, Soulja.
And then Bow Wow, Bow Easy, Shad Moss has 3.8 million followers.
Okay, all right.
Yeah, not bad. I'll take it, you know, for a guy who's 2'9". Yeah, I'll take it.
Then he got a baby, Bow Wow.
Yeah, he does. And he wants to kill himself.
Yeah, I heard. People be posting everything on social media.
Too much.
I just don't understand it.
Too much.
I know, like in our line of work, being entertainers, being podcasters, being actors, being all that stuff, social media is important for our work, you know, just building a fan base. I am so bad at it.
Yeah, because you post the same picture of you at the sink with your butt out. And we resend it to a group chat, like, what is this guy doing? Every single time. And he's like, it's nice. And we're like, no, that's not what we said.
No. I'm bad because I can't, like, do the stories a lot because I just don't care. And, like, even
you
when I'm
watching stories?
No, like, doing the stories.
No,
like,
but do you watch them?
Yeah, I do watch stories. I watch certain people's stories, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. I used to watch your snaps when you used to do your story snaps. Your story,
Snapchat.
Yeah.
The story. Yeah.
I don't really go on Snapchat anymore though. But
nobody does.
And no, I sometimes I just go weeks. I'm trying to post more. I'm trying to post more frequently.
Do you ever? Oh, you don't post stories.
Yeah, I don't really post it unless I'm like singing in my car or posting a meme or something.
Do you ever check to see like, oh, did that one person check?
You know, when Instagram first like brought that out, I used to.
Mm-hmm.
Now I don't really care who looks. Damn. I don't give a fuck.
Savage Devion, I like it.
What? I mean, it's just if they can look, they look. If they don't, they don't. What I do though, because sometimes when I get drunk, because I don't save numbers, I don't save people numbers that I would might text. I will let people text me first. I won't text them. So like,
and they'll know who it is.
I'll know who it is by because I won't. About a conversation that we had, but even if I erase it, I've already kind of learned the first digits, so I don't know who's texting me, who's calling me. But usually I do that just so I won't text these people when I don't really want to. So, but when I get drunk, sometimes I Instagram certain people, like I DM them, and I've become a DMer, and I don't want.
I'm a DMer.
I don't want shit, and it's so sad. I have DM certain people saying like, "Are you gay?" And like just like these people I don't know from like they probably never got it because it's probably in that lost file.
Yeah,
hopefully.
Yeah. I hate the lost file.
But also I've started to mute people's like stories and posts just so I don't see it. Cause if I'm lit,
you
like,
see it.
I see it. I'm gonna like, especially if I'm just like out and about. It's usually somebody that I know that we communicate through IG, like mm-hmm. we talk in a way through IG and not through text message.
Mm-hmm.
And so like I have this thing of if I'm at a bar something, I'm going to like some if we're having a kiki at somebody's house or having a kiki or whatever, then I'll say, hey, we're doing so and so, come over, what are you guys doing? Or like mm-hmm. so like, cause it's a very inviting type of thing. It's mm-hmm. not like a let me get over and suck your dick. It's just like
no,
like,
yeah, of course. Nah,
no,
yeah.
No, but seriously.
Nah, yeah, for sure.
So I'm just like I am so thankful for Instagram for having the mute option. I do it to a lot of people, and I enjoy that.
You know what I am now?
I enjoy it.
I'm a blocker.
You actually physically block people. Yeah. Not physically, but literally block people.
Yeah. I just started doing it a month ago.
On what? On Instagram?
On everything.
Why do you block them? Blocking, they know when you block them, though, don't they?
Sort of. Like, if you block them and then they search for you and you don't pop up, they either think you deleted your Instagram or you blocked them.
Oh. Why you go so far as to block? When you mute, you just don't see their shit. They can see yours.
Some people, I don't want them to see my stuff.
Okay, that's different. That's different, okay.
For me, because I went through a thing this summer, like end of the summer, and it got to me. So I was like, you know what? I'm a
block. You were in your feelings like Drake.
I was in my feelings like, damn, Drake, the cultural icon. Mm-hmm. Who threw a 90s, early 2000 party, and I wish I could have went to it.
Where?
Here in L.A.
Don't they usually invite people? I saw somebody there. I think my friend Zach was there.
Really?
Yeah.
Friggin' Zach. Shout out to Zach. Hmm? Shout out to Zach.
Shout out to him. He's probably not listening to this. I pissed him off last time. But anyway, we won't talk about him.
You giving him the bad juge?
I don't give anybody bad anything.
You giving him the bad juge?
No. I can't talk about that because he'll know who I'm talking about. But even if I start to say what I'm saying.
We're sorry.
Sorry.
Okay, Zach. okay, we're moving on. But anyways, I was in my feelings this summer, so I block like hella people. I even block people on my phone now.
You should.
I block numbers.
I think it's healthy. I think it's so.
Oh my gosh,
healthy.
It felt great because like sometimes I will go back and look at my story and see who watched it, and it used to bother me. It's like. It was like, why you don't text me back, but you can watch my story.
Yeah.
So it got to me. I was just like, man, you know what? As a form of punishment, you can't look at none of my stuff no more.
Delete people out of your life. I'm just playing.
Nah, but it's the truth.
Out of sight, out of mind.
I haven't deleted people out of my life.
It is an emotional necessity to make sure you take care of self.
Yep.
Like if I told a couple of friends of mine that we stopped talking and now we're kind of cool again. We're talking. We're rebuilding our friendship. But I told them because they asked me, they was like, why did you block us and do this and this? And I said, well, seeing photos of you guys doing this and doing that, it made me emotionally strained. It made me sad. I didn't like it. I felt left out. All these feelings that I didn't want to feel, I started feeling. Start to feel it. Then I muted you or blocked you, and I was able to come out to terms with what the relationship that I had with you was. And, you know, out of sight, out of mind, I just started not to care about that anymore. It wasn't that I knew that my worth. And then seeing your pictures and stuff like that made me question who I was as a person. That, well, maybe I'm not good enough to hang out with you. Maybe you know what I mean? It was just like, it wasn't a safe space for me to live in, especially having all the mental issues I used to have or have. So
now they're gone.
Yeah.
Not for me too.
Crazy, y'all.
It was like a gateway to communication, right? Because the thing that I was getting out of, it happened suddenly, abruptly, right? And so for me, I gotta get all the way away. Like, right. don't keep, like, texting me and hitting me up. So, at first, it was like, all right, cool. This is over? Cool. Then you watch my story. Then you think I'm funny. So, because you think I'm funny, you gonna respond to it. You know? And it got to the point where I was like, you know what? I can't be having you, you know, communicate with me still. So, it got to the point where I delete you on one thing. And then they was hitting me up on another thing. Then I blocked you on that, and it was hitting me. Shoot, they hit me up. I didn't even recognize that I ain't block them. I just unfriended them on something, and they still hit me up. I was like,
oh, really?
Dude.
I do the unfriend. I like that.
I love it.
The unfollow. I do unfollow.
Unfollow? Uh-uh. They need to know that I hate them.
See, and they need to know, and I think they should, because they're reaching out to you. They're still trying to keep a relationship going.
You're nah, like, don't
you
know, do like, that.
Hey, I can't do that. You can't have your cake and eat it too.
Nope, I'm not cake eater. Like, I'm a human.
You were this way towards me, and I have learned that silence is sometimes the loudest type of noise.
Yep.
I don't need you to know I'm pissed. Or I'm not pissed. I just could give two fucks.
Right.
But yeah. I know emotionally I don't want to get to a place where it makes me upset, where it makes me pissed. So as soon as I start to feel that, like, oh, that nigga's trying to get on my, trying to block it. It's like, I don't have time. It's 2018.
Speak on it, King.
I don't got time for it.
Yep.
Ain't got time for it. Last time we talked, there was about the Brett Kavanaugh or whatever was about to get sworn in or was been investigated, and now he has been sworn in to the Supreme Court. How does that make you feel?
You know what? It makes me think more about the people than about Brett Kavanaugh.
Right.
Because it was a lot of noise while things were happening.
Yeah.
But once he overcame it, you ain't hear nothing.
Yeah, I mean,
I didn't hear very much.
I think people are talking more now because you have everybody go out and vote. Go vote, 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 vote. Midterm elections on November 6th. Go vote. I have a couple of friends that are offering their vehicles if you don't have a way to get to and fro. I am not one of those friends.
And if you're in Florida, vote for Andrew Gillum.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. His clapback. Woo.
That was hardcore.
you know, racist. Think you're racist. That was funny. I have this, like, I don't know. I mean, everything is so sensitive and so touchy and so, like, sad that most times I have to always block out things and just kind of, like,
keep it pushing.
Keep it, because if something's going to happen, I'm going to find out about it. It's going to find its way to my news feed, to my something, to something. I'm going to some conversation and I'm going to hear, I'm like, oh, then I'm going to look it up. But other than that, y'all, find some joy in something. Find some peace of mind. Like, don't get lost. I know everything is so important right now, and it is. Our lives are dependent. Our lives are in danger. You're in danger, girl.
Hide your kids.
Hide your wives. Hide your husband, too. They coming for everybody.
I will say this. I think every dog gets its day.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Absolutely. So it's like, okay, I understand he gets sworn in today. And that's a stain on our history. It's a stain on our culture. Not to say that, you know, we don't already have a lot of stains. A
lot of them.
But today doesn't dictate every day. And I actually was watching some videos about Bill Cosby this week.
Mm?
And to find out that in the early 90s and the late 80s, he used to squander a lot of his money paying off women through this other dude, because he didn't want the funds to come directly from him. So he used to give this guy money, and this guy would pay off women, and the guy didn't know why he was doing it. He was just paying them, like, man, Bill Cosby's going to pay him. And of course now we know why.
Yeah.
You know, so think about it.
In the
late 80s, he's the man. He's doing whatever he wants. And then eventually, he gets what's coming to him. So it may have came later than we wanted it to. But overall, I don't look at this as a
loss.
You know, it's a loss. You know, every team got to lose a game here and there. But that don't mean that you you know, you lost the whole series or you lost everything. To me, it's like, it's a loss. Okay, this time. But, you know, we can, we as an informed group of people, we as the generation that's going to come into these positions, you know, sooner than later, you know, we have to take this and say, okay, the people who are there right now, they made XYZ mistakes. And when it's our turn to take those seats, to do these coveted jobs and roles, it's gonna be on our end,
right?
We have to fix, you know, it directly, not as, you know, a voice, but as a you know, physical group of people who are doing the job. It's gonna be up to us to make these changes. So to me, I feel bad for the people that, you know, were affected, and to see him, you know, succeed, that sucks,
right?
You know, that sucks, and I'm sure it's painful. However, that doesn't mean that you should stop fighting and whatnot. So that's why I said I was surprised by the people, because people was just like, oh,
Right. I don't think so. I think the noise kind of died a little bit more on some of the social media outlets, but I still think there's people out there still trying to figure out how to overcome this and you know, to stop him from going to even getting sworn in would be one thing, but now that he's sworn in, how can we change the rules? How can we change the laws? I don't think anybody should have a lifetime appointment on anything. Anyway, yeah, I just think that's stupid. I mean, come on. The way time changed, the way the world, the way our minds, you know, to even think that, you know, that we are now learning about multiple genders and sexualities and all this stuff is new to not just straight people, the hetero world, to a lot of different people. So it's like the world is moving and it's changing and we have to be able to change and grow and learn from it and with it. 7 Seconds was a good Netflix show and it got canceled. I got pissed off because I watched it because it just was sad. But
that's why I don't watch
it. Have you seen it?
No.
It's just a reflection on what we know that happens every day in our lives.
I don't watch none of these shows.
I got a near my body.
All right. Devion's got to go nudify.
I have to go. Guys, have fun Halloween. I have 4 costumes. I'm super excited.
Goodness. All for this weekend?
Well, 2 are for this weekend and 1 is for actual Halloween. If you guys go to the West Hollywood Parade, let me know. It's on Halloween every year on Wednesday. I'll be there. I'm dressing as a unicorn with some friends.
Like a sexy unicorn?
You know, they just decided to do unicorns, and they told me today, and I said, okay, because I was going to do Pikachu.
Hey, yellow Ferrari like a Pikachu.
But it was just a Pikachu having some yellow draws. But so
that sounds about right for you.
I was like, oh, I got to do a little bit more creative than that. I used to get a tail or something.
Yeah.
But yeah. Okay, guys. I'm out of here because I got to drive from the valley. It's going to take a whole 20 minutes. Because ain't no traffic right now.
That's going to be the name of the episode, 20 minutes. All right, y'all. You know, rest in peace to Peter Davidson's relationship with Ariana Grande.
And to Mac Miller.
But also, if you did that to Mac Miller, yeah, we going to...
Yeah, dude, you kind of trash for doing that shit. Yeah, like, fuck you, for real, but not for real, but for real, though, dude. For real. But also, I like you for calling out Kanye West and telling him to get on his meds, because he needs to get on his meds. And Kanye West is a genius. He is a genius.
I'm not going to say that.
Musically, I think he is. I think he's great. I haven't listened to his new stuff yet, just because I can't. But I can't stop listening to R. Kelly.
No, we're gonna bleep that.
Please.
No, we're not. Hey, real quick about Kanye meeting with Donald Trump. He took like 3 steps forward and then like 11 steps back.
I just think something's wrong.
No, nothing's wrong. I'm sick and tired of this notion that something's wrong with
you
Kanye.
Think he's stupid.
I think
he's just that's his choice. He has every right to have the choice he has. But
I'm gonna be honest with you, Kanye West, when he spoke to Donald Trump, the things he said was all on point. He said a bunch. He said 90% of the things he said was fine. And something that most things I agreed with. The problem was, I love this guy, and this hat makes me feel like Superman, and Hillary's not my dad. It was like, bro, you were doing so good. I'm tired of this notion that Kanye West is sick. He's not sick. He admitted it already that he wasn't sleeping very much for a long time, and that affected his mood. So when he went to the hospital, they thought he was bipolar. But once they realized that he didn't sleep properly for a long period of time, he's not actually bipolar. So I think it was a mistake for him to actually pretty much admit that. But there's nothing wrong with Kanye West. There's nothing wrong with his mental health.
That's what you say.
There's nothing wrong with him. He's just a guy who's an entertainer who's from the day one, he knows how to attract attention. So let's throw the
mental. He's a narcissist.
Fine. He's a narcissist.
Which however, I don't always think that's a bad thing. I've been called that. But
really?
I have been.
Oh.
I don't think I'm a narcissist at all. But
no, yeah.
Yeah, not in the least. Man.
All right, so this was a good day. No, this was a good podcast. No, we're going to catch you later.
We're going to try to come back next week.
Kelby and the narcissist Devion.
Bye, bitches. All right,
we'll see you
Go
guys
suck a dick and have fun. Good life.
No. We'll see you guys in 20 minutes.